Let's break it down with Fox News senior strategic analyst General Jack Keane. General, always good to have you.
Good to see you, Shannon.
Okay, so what do you make tonight? We're told that Central Command, that is the entity that requested the additional 1,000 troops to head over to the Middle East. A lot of folks asking questions tonight about how this squares with the president's America First strategy, the getting us out of these overseas incursions situation.
Well, I think it particularly squares with Iranians' aggressive malign behavior for 39 years. The president pulled out of the nuclear deal that was formed in 2015. He did it because Iran was going to be on a path to nuclear weapons, and the Obama administration, very early on in the negotiations, because Iran didn't want any part of it, took off the table their aggressive behavior for 39 years in Lebanon, Syria, Iraq, and finally Yemen. The year of the deal is when they took down the government in Yemen. So I think this, what the Trump administration is doing, is fundamentally trying to change Iran's behavior, not just the nuclear weapons, but their aggressive behavior in the Middle East. And I think it's working because the sanctions are crippling them. They've gotten obviously a little bit more desperate here. And I think Iran's strategy here is really to use the international community, Europeans, even Japan, to put pressure on the United States to back off. Mm-hmm. That's what disrupting the world's main oil artery in the Middle East is about. And that is what, as you mentioned in the introduction, their threat to breach the nuclear deal. And if they do breach it, I think they'll breach it rather slightly as opposed to overwhelmingly, because I still think they want to pull the Europeans to them.
Yeah, and that's kind of the conundrum now, I think, for this administration. The AP putting it this way today: the Trump administration found itself in the awkward position Monday of demanding that Iran comply with a nuclear accord that the president has derided the worst deal in history. So do we now, the U.S., put pressure on our European allies to stick to the deal, to hold Iran to the deal, the one we've walked away from?
Well, I think what the Trump administration is saying is that they don't want Iran to be on a path to a nuclear weapon, period. That really is their issue. And I also think from the outset, because remember, the president, he didn't like the deal, and he let his advisors go out and try to rework it with the UK, with France and Germany, to see if they could make a better deal. And when, after a year or so of that, they struck out. He always maintained, and I somewhat agree with this, that he wants to go back to the negotiating table. Mm-hmm. And the pressure of the sanctions is to draw the Iranians back. I don't think the Iranians are prepared for any of that yet, because their objective, and the one thing that people have got to understand, the Iranians have never backed off on their objective to dominate and control the Middle East, spread the Islamic revolution. And they literally have made progress at that every single year.
Well, I want to give you a chance to respond to critics of the president who say he's to blame for where we are now with Iran. A freshman Democrat Congresswoman Ilhan Omar tweeting this: none of this would be happening if Trump didn't back out of the Iran nuclear deal. America's response should be to return to the table and reinstate the Iran nuclear deal. Increasing tensions and threats of war serve nobody's interests.
That's such rubbish, because the very year of the deal, Iran Houthis toppled the government in Yemen, which is friendly to the United States, and we have this human catastrophe that's going on, even though there was negotiations going on for 2 years, that if we made this deal with the Iranians, they will join the responsible nations of the international community and behave accordingly. Just a few weeks ago, every single one of the 600 rockets and missiles that were fired from the Gaza Strip into Israel all came from Iran. They're in Syria, encroaching on Israel, trying to set up small bases and put rockets and missiles there. The Israelis have flown over 100 missions into Syria in 18 months to stop that from happening. So Iran has been on the march, despite the fact that there was a deal. They got a windfall of $130 billion as a result of the deal. And Shannon, the international community hoped that they would invest that in their country and change their behavior. What did they do with that money? They invested it in their proxies and their warlike manner in the Middle East. And that's why the civil unrest in the country to this day, coupled with the sanctions that are also hurting the people.
All right, well, we'll watch minute by minute. There are developments there. General, always good to have you.
Yeah. Good talking to you, Shannon.